Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week, we're on the Feather River wrapping up Brad's K16 killer fish and catching big, beautiful fall run king salmon. If you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. It's O-Dark 30 on the Feather River, a tributary of the Sacramento River in Northern California. We're trolling for striped bass, but not for long, because the stripers won't bite. But starting at 6, the salmon will.
Good morning, everybody.
Okay, here's what's going on. So, we got a big old swirling eddy, and it's all rock bottom, so we got this giant anchor, and it helps me hold in position. We got cold water in the low flow running down the Feather River to keep our river cold. That's what hatchery's right up here. And then we got warm water coming up out of the after bay, dropping down a hill right into this, creates a giant pond. So all the fish are laying where the cold water's meeting the warmer water. It's getting pretty close in the temperature, but the fish are laying right there in this deep hole, and it goes from 20 feet and just crawls right on down into 40. So we got to set exactly right there. I always make fun of everybody and say I can't afford a spot lock trolling motor. That would really work good, but I break them as fast as I can buy them, so I quit. I just gave up on them. So we're gonna use this big heavy anchor. We're gonna get key position. We've been getting fish there every day, so we're expecting, you know, we've been hooking 4 or 5 a day. We land on 4 or 5 and then great. If we get a couple, that'd be great too, but that's what's gonna happen this morning.
So there's a lot of stuff to this season.
Bunch of fish coming through. We got about 10 minutes till we can get started here. Pretty promising sign of what's to come once we get the lures in the water.
Well, what we're gonna do here, we got a little dropper on here and it slides, and that's where your weight goes. The reason why we rig it like that, so when you're netting these big fish in this current, if you get this hung up in the net, then it will slide and your drag will go out with the fish that's connected to your flatfish will be on here, your killer fish. And so with that sliding, it sticks in the net, gives you time to cut it off and that, and your fish can run off and do its thing. So, and then we'll hook our plug on here. This is an old Kenai Rainbow with a sardine wrapper on it. And that's it, right there. Yeah, it's about 6 o'clock, you can start fishing for salmon. We were already striper fishing and that, so we can start salmon fishing now. We're trying to get a little current, get our lures working. It hooks back around a back eddy here, so it's a 40-foot hole out here. There's an apron that goes across, it's all cement, and you'll see guys casting out there with the lights on. They're trying to bead one up with a hook and a bead. And we're running these underneath right to the edge of the apron because it goes straight down into 40 feet of water. And we got a big school of fish that just circles around in here. Later on, we'll go downriver and fish the little pockets and that. But we always start off here and see what happens. It's always good for a couple fish. Hard to get your lure to work. Really, you got to constantly pick it up and try to find current with your lure. When you get it to work real good, then you can back it out a little more.
So what we're doing here, guys, is we're backing our lures and up underneath this current. We're holding them, we're finding bottom. It's kind of hard to keep our lures working, keep them pumping good. There's fish.
Back to the Feather River. I'm Justin Wolf. It's just a few minutes past legal fishing time, and we have our first hookup of the morning, a recently arrived Fall Run King Salmon.
There he is. That's a Kenai Rainbow K16, Brad's killer fish. One of our favorites.
Grab that bat over there.
That Kenai Rainbow is my favorite. I love that lure, man. I don't know what it is, but they like that Kenai Rainbow. A while back, we started using that. I think we were up in Las Molinas, huh, Whoopi, when we did the show up there. Man, that lure's hot. Really good lure. Great color. I don't know what it is. I know it's dark out, but you know, I don't care when it is. I'll always put that one on. It's a good one.
I was using a 1 ounce. I'm going to switch over to a 2 ounce here. Keep them away. The current's real slow and just a fine little line you got to find the bottom on.
Oh, two. And
try to keep it away from everybody else's stuff. Just traded out lures. I was using the Brad's K16, the double trouble.
Don't slide up the side, brother.
Put on the dragonfly and got bit right away.
Beautiful fish. These are new fish. New fish. They're gorgeous.
So this is the dragonfly here. Sardine wrap on the bottom of it. I was running the double trouble the first part of the morning. Had a bite on it. Just traded this one out. Fresh lure and got bit right away. As you can see, nice clean fish. It's always been a good lure. Every lure has been good today though. Party Time's gotten bit. Kenai Rainbow. Like usual, the Brads are producing.
What we're doing is we come here, we're gonna give it about an hour, and normally we just a few hours here and then we go to row, but the fish are bright and chrome. We've had obviously a new run of fish come in today. They're jumping all around in here, so we'll probably get one or two more here and then we'll go downriver. We got some spots we want to try down there. Completely different fly line. It's just a different way of fishing. It's a lot easier. This is a crazy back head. It's hard to get your lure to work in that, but as you can see, it's very productive. So anyways, we'll give it a little bit longer here and then we'll go show you guys something else.
Yep, fresh bait. So I'm gonna rewrap that same lure. It just got bit. Take a pair of scissors on your sardine fillet here. You wanna trim it. You're basically squaring it up so it lays on your plug nice and flat. You take your fillet. You usually get about two baits out of them. Trim it there and you make a nice little section right down the middle. And what that does there is it creates an area to where you could take your Brad's killer fish here slide your lure. Oh, gotta check that eyelet. Always check your eyelets. Straighten them up. You take that sardine fillet, put it right in there. And then you get some of this Procure sardine juice. Put a little bit in there in the middle of it.
Monster. Welcome back, and I hope you're enjoying this week's episode from the Feather River, where we're catching some fantastic fall run Chinook salmon with guide Raith Herford. Now, Raith made a big deal about the Dragonfly K16 Brad's killer fish. He's got a lot of confidence in this lure, and it's a great lure. Now, why does he have so much confidence in it? Well, because he's caught a bunch of fish with it. And it reminds me of a time I was bass fishing on Shasta Lake with Uncle Bill. And Uncle Bill was throwing a spinnerbait, and he caught a nice fish, and he turned to me and he said, "You know why I catch so many fish on a spinnerbait?" I said, "No, why, Uncle Bill? Why do you catch so many fish on a spinnerbait?" He says, "Because I throw it a lot." Well, there you go. It's all about confidence. Race got this lure, this dragonfly, in the water a lot, so of course he catches more fish with it. And it's a good lure on top of that. Now, he also likes to use the Party Time, which is my all-time favorite, and also the Kenai Rainbow, another great color. And you can see there's some similarities in colors and so forth, but the reason Raith likes those three particular lures in general, and there's a couple others too, like the Double Trouble, but when Brad's first started to market these lures down in California, I took these three colors down to Raith, and that's where he was introduced to them. And so since then, he's caught an awful lot of fish in them, and that's his confidence colors. So, you know, it's what I tell people in the shop here. They come in, I say, you know, I don't sell lures so much, I sell confidence. The lures just come with that. So when you get a lure that works, regardless of what color it is, you're going to build confidence in that. And this is the confidence lure that Raith really likes to use. Now, Raith's the kind of guy, you know, there's fishy people in this world, and Raith's one of them. Raith can do everything wrong and still catch fish. You know, it's just one of those weird cosmic things. But I'm going to talk to you a little bit about a few things you can do to the killer fish to maybe improve your catch ratio. Now, you notice when they're wrapping the sardine wrap on these, okay, they're slipping it in and it's going right up under the belly here. Now, what you want to make sure you're doing is get most of the weight towards the front of the lure, okay? If it's up here, that means the weight's going to push that bill down a little bit, and you want your lure running down like this, so it'll be side to side with that motion and not flat like this. You get a better, more vibration, more traction. It just, you want your lure to have that nice unlevel action like that. So the way you do that is just by sliding that sardine wrap up towards the front. Very simple. And when you're wrapping it on, I like to use this ghost thread, this Fishfield ghost thread. This stuff's awesome. It's very strong, and it'll slice through that sardine wrap and release more scent. And also, it's a good value. So you look at the price here, $7.95, and you might think, oh, that's a lot for thread, but you're getting two spools of thread. It's way more than twice as much as what you get with other types of thread. And also this nice handy little plastic container that holds it while you're wrapping it, so you're keeping your thread nice and clean. So that's a really good deal. It's per yard, much less expensive than other types of thread. I really like this thread. Now, another thing you can do is extend out the hooks. Now, here's a Party Time, and I've caught an awful lot of fish on this color pattern down the Sacramento River. That was before killer fish, so that would have been a quick fish, but they had the same basic color pattern. I called it a strawberry butt back then. I don't know what the real name for it was, but this is my confidence lure right here. And what I've done is extended out the hooks, so you can see they're on a swivel. That's a number 4 Spro Power Swivel. Spend the extra dollar on good swivels. They won't fail you. But I've extended the hooks out. So having that little bit of extra length might help you catch more fish. But really what's going on, if we take a look at this one that hasn't been adjusted. If you got that, say that fish has got the rear hook here and you're pulling on the front of the lure and he's twisting on the back here, you can twist it right off. Okay, and anybody that fishes for coho knows that happens a lot. Well, king salmon can do the same thing. Now what I've done here is taken a good strong pair of needle nose pliers and tweaked that eyelet out a little bit so I could slide in the swivel. And then very carefully, straight up and down, push it back in the shape. Now be careful when you're doing this because these hooks are sharp. I've poked plenty of holes in myself doing that. And then you just, with the needle, good pair of split ring pliers, you're going to just open up that split ring and assemble your hook back together just like that. Then when you've got that fish on and you're pulling on the front of the lure and he's pulling on the back, he can't use the lure for leverage to twist off. So that's a real big advantage you just given yourself. Now split ring pliers are absolutely essential for any fisherman. In the shop here, I've got two really good types of pliers by P-Line. This one has a lead post included with it, a lead post punch. Now, if you subscribe to my YouTube channel, I'll put up a video soon that shows how to use that lead post punch, which is an extremely effective technique, especially for side drifting. And then here's another version of split ring pliers that has the crimpers built in. So if you're doing some crimping, that's a really great tool. These are stainless steel for $22. That's a great deal. These are $14.99. So well worth that small investment for some good pliers. Now after this short break, we're going back to the Feather River to see if we can't get another hookup. Welcome back to the Feather River. I'm Justin Wolf. It's a beautiful morning, especially if you're dropping K16s into the big hole.
Oh, monster. Take four. God. The tug's the drug, guys. Unbelievable. Massive head shakes. These Talon Angler West rods are killing them. Love them. Here we go. Here we go. We're going hard. We're going to get his head down. Oh, we got an old black boot, but here we go. 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 It's a darker one. It's a little bit darker fish. We might let this one go. Actually, it's pretty. It's not bad. It's actually not that bad. We had a bad year on salmon. We might want to keep it. That was great, guys. This is a classic takedown. Just come up and it just throttled. Boom. Fish on. So, yeah, shoot. Everybody around's catching them too today. So, it's a pretty good day. Not bad. Got a late start.
We've got real warm water this year in the river. We're gonna give this a shot here. It's the water soluble fish oil, the garlic. Every once in a while, and give it a little spray when after your lure's been down there a little bit. Gives it some smell to it, and garlic's real potent. They can smell it really well underwater. It'll stick on there and then slowly wash out as that lure's down there swimming.
All right, guys. Well, that's the guaranteed spot. You always get them there, so. What we're gonna do now is go downriver. We're gonna fly line or use a half ounce weight in the ripples, get in the shallow water, catch them running through. They always hold up there in that cold water. That's the low flow where it meets the outlet. So anyway, so we'll get down here and we'll do that. We'll get on this flat. We've been getting some fish down here, so we'll see what happens. But
We got very optimistic today with all the new fish arriving. I don't know why they're late this year, but man, they're nice fish, brand new fish. We're hoping for a big October and maybe even a November in California this year for the fish. We still have good water, a lot of water coming out. I think it's 2,500 still. So great morning. I think we ended up 7 fish that were on that grabbed it. 5 of them fighting and 3 of them made it in the boat. So it's a tough place to land a fish, but is what it is. Great time. The best bite there is that the plug bite.
We're gonna go with about.
You got fresh lure?
No, I don't.
Little tiny wave on that slide. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Won't be long now.
Everybody, thanks for watching today's episode. And be sure to stop by the Angler West store in Woodland, Washington. I'm sure we can help you catch more fish. And remember, without the sponsors, there is no show. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.